Wir sind noch am Greenfield Festival 2015 und neben mir jetzt die Band Asking Alexandria. How are you doing, guys?
Good, man. Just trying to get drunk, but I got told I had to hide my beer thingy, so I had to get another thingy to put my beer in, and it's really complicated.
Good thing talking about it when we said, no, we shouldn't be showing that we've got beer here. It could be anything but this, man.
No, this is the way it is. This is apple juice.
It's apple juice. Well, that was a quick. Shouldn't show that. Also, es ihnen geht's gut. Sie haben etwas zu trinken da. Sie sind natürlich zufrieden und wir sind auch zufrieden. So you arrived. It's raining in Switzerland. You're in Switzerland. I mean, what's about that? Normally it's mountains, sunshine. Normalerweise ist es Bergen und Sonnenschein. Und jetzt regnet es da am Greenfield. Man sieht es da natürlich in dem Moment nicht. Aber was ist Ihre Meinung dazu? The rain in Switzerland. I mean, you have got that in England already. Why should you go to other countries and it rains on your head? I mean, that's just bad.
That's what I'm saying. And we woke up and it was sunny and we were hot. And we were like, yes, this is awesome. Look how beautiful it is. There were naked women walking around. It was awesome but strange. And then it started raining and they all put their clothes back on.
That's actually really sad. I mean, normally it's good when the women stay naked. I guess also the men sometimes, because the women also like to see, like, you know, naked upper body from men sometimes.
Not me.
Although I'm not me either. I mean, I'm not a fan of that, you know, taking my clothes off, because, you know, it's just, you don't want to show.
I've got a dad bod going on under
really?
This.
Really? Yeah. A dad bod? Yeah. You can't see a dad bod,
I pretty much look like
a little boy.
Like a seven-year-old.
Like a seven-year-old boy?
Yeah.
That's because he has a small.
Also, das Wetter ist momentan gut, weil sie sagen, hey, heute Morgen war es schön, die Frauen sind nachts rumgelaufen und jetzt hat es angefangen zu regnen und die Frauen haben ihre Kleider wieder angezogen. Was fast ein bisschen schade ist, ich habe gefunden, für Frauen wäre es ja eigentlich schön, auch wenn man sich die Mann ausziehen würde. Er findet nein, vor allem er wird das selber nicht ausziehen, weil er hat einen Deadbot. Das ist ja dort, wo man das sogenannte kleine Büchli hat. I know the word that, but it's there where you got that little, you know, that little tummy when you drink too much of that, I guess.
Beer belly,
yeah, little beer belly. Anyway, so I've been seeing on your Instagram accounts, you've got this big hashtag AA family going on.
Yeah.
Sie haben auf Instagram und Facebook groß hashtag AA family. Das steht natürlich für Asking Alexandra. You put a picture up on there, and I've been seeing you doing a lot of selfies and putting them on your Instagram account.
It's because I'm really good looking.
But you've got a dad bod.
I've got a dad bod, but I don't take pictures of that. I get the angle just right so they can't see the dad bod.
Well, apparently. Really
wait, he's got to speak in the microphone.
Apparently, they're really loving the dad bod.
Is that like
it's
that?
It's the new six pack, apparently.
So, of all the fans you've got, you'll have even more fans because it's like, wait a sec, Asking Alexandria, they've got the dad bod going on. But they wouldn't know you've got a dad bod if you don't take your t-shirts off on stage.
Well, I've just told everyone.
All right. Well, that means everybody will have to watching our show.
Exactly.
You think everybody's watching our show from the whole world?
Everyone.
You think we're that big?
6 billion people.
All right, also, wir haben gesagt, hey, wenn Sie natürlich wollen, dass wir wissen, dass Sie in Deadpool haben, extrem gut aussehen, um sich auf Instagram zeigen mit Ihrem ganzen Körper, dann machen Sie es auch, aber im langen Zeit, wenn es nur schon euch sagt, weil er hat ja einen Deadpool und wenn er das sagt, würden es auch alle Joyce-Zuschauer mitbekommen. But the hashtag AA family, what is that to you? Because, I mean, not a lot of bands do that these days. Put a lot of stuff up on Facebook, put a lot of stuff on pop on Instagram. I mean, it looks like, it seems like it's really, really important to your band that it's just, you know, that's the way you move at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, our fan base kind of named themselves the AA family, you know, and it's a pretty spectacular thing. Like, our fan base is very, very loyal, not just to us, but to each other, and it's become over the years more of a family than it has, you know, just a fan base and a bunch of people that like the same band. Everyone's very supportive of each other. And of the band, and it's just grown into this huge worldwide family that it's almost uncontrollable at this point. Now it's just sort of spreading, and it's really nice to see fans from all around the world making friends, looking out for each other, you know, with the same likes and interests. And basically, yeah, it was all them. It wasn't even us. They sort of named themselves the AA family, and it's really, really taken off. So it's pretty awesome to see.
Also, ich habe gefragt, Sie haben wirklich mega viel Wert gelegt auf die sogenannte Hashtag AA-Familie, weil es ist natürlich wichtig für junge Bands heutzutage, dass sie über soziale Medien richtig viele Leute erreichen können. Aber Ihrer Meinung nach, Sie sagen, dass die Familie eigentlich von der Fans gestanden ist, dass sie das gegründet haben und sie haben es einfach auch übernommen und mit dem fahren sie grundsätzlich weiter, damit es auch so funktionieren tut. Now, big news. 1 week ago, new singer, big concert, Czech Republic. I mean, sie haben jetzt einen neuen Sänger. Es hat ein bisschen Probleme gegeben, über die werden wir später reden. Und es ist der Dennis. Where is Dennis right now? Is he not ready for interviews yet? Wo ist Dennis jetzt? Ist er noch nicht bereit für die Interviews? Ihr neuer Sänger?
He's ready for interviews, but he's like a caged animal. We're keeping him locked away. We're like, no, you can't come and hang out with us. you're the new guy. He has to stay in his bunk on his own and just be quiet.
Is that like that? Put him in a cage.
Yeah.
Lock him onto the table.
Yeah.
Just leave him with he can't drink anything, I guess.
No. Nope.
Keep him like
no
white
booze.
And pale,
no
you
booze.
Know, like.
Exactly. No booze, right. No sun, no food.
We
exploit him with sexual favors.
Oh, for sure, yeah. I think yesterday was his first alcoholic drink of the tour. We let him have one drink.
But that means he was very nice all day.
Oh, he's been just wanting to drink with us like the whole time. But it's, you know, like trying to take care of his voice and, you know, whatever. But, you know, last night was, he was pretty happy about the situation, so.
But he didn't get drunk. He just had a drink.
No. Just,
you
just,
you
just,
wouldn't let him have more drinks than one.
Well, I mean, I offered him a second one, I think. But no, he's pretty professional. So it's like he's very, very professional.
He's also got.
He cares about his voice. You know, unlike our last singer, who just couldn't care less. Like Dennis wants to sound his best. He wants to do a good job. So he really only drinks if you have a day off the next day. You know, so his voice can recover. It's pretty cool.
Interesting fact, you just talked about your last singer and now your new singer, and you as a band have got the new song coming out, or came out, which is called I Won't Give In.
Yep.
And it's got interesting lyrics. I mean, did you write the lyrics, or who wrote the lyrics to that song?
I wrote 50% of the lyrics, and Dennis wrote the other 50%. So like,
because I read the lyrics and I wasn't sure, are we talking about a woman, which might have been in Dennis' case, or are we talking about your last singer you had in the band?
Well, that's the interesting thing, because I wrote half the lyrics and Dennis wrote the other half. It's kind of like, it's open to interpretation, you know. Obviously, I was talking on you know what's happened. I was kind of like talking about Danny and what happened with Danny, and then I guess Dennis has his own things he needs to, you know, address, and it just kind of all came together as that one song. So it's definitely a song that's open to interpretation, but there's definitely a lot of lyrical thrown at towards our ex dude, Mr. Danny Warsnop.
But I did see an interview that you did actually talk about not wanting to make the new album, which, is it coming out soon or will it be coming out the next few months?
We're hoping to release the new album sort of October, November right. time, so not too long.
But you've been talking about that in the new album, it shouldn't be about Danny, your ex-singer. It should be more about the new band and everything. So if you just said that you've been like, you know, trying throwing some things at your ex-singer.
We're not going out of our way to try and talk about that, you know? It's like, we're not a new band, but it's, you know, new member. We're not trying to talk shit. You know?
We want it to be more positive than anything. Obviously, there's some songs that are going to be geared more towards what we've been through because, you know, as artists, you have to put your heart and passion into what you're writing and singing about. So obviously, there's some stuff that's about what happened with Danny. But for the most part, we're all really happy about the change. Like, none of us are bitter or angry, and we're having a good time now. So the album on the whole, I think, is a lot more positive. We're not really concentrating on being upset with Danny because we're not upset, you know.
But are you still in contact with him or not anymore?
Are we what?
In contact with Danny.
Not really. Every now and again, like, I'll get a text from him. How's it going? Yeah, it's good. All right. That's about it.
But it's on good terms then. I mean, you ask yourself, you know, how you're doing and stuff.
Kind of, yeah,
all right,
I guess.
Okay. Also, jetzt vorne mitbekommen, sie haben einen neuen Sänger. Ihr neuer Sänger hat letzte Woche sein allererstes Konzert gehabt und sie findet den neuen Sänger, ja, den darf man noch nicht wirklich so ein bisschen dran lassen. Der muss noch ein bisschen langsam dran kommen, noch nicht gerade mega Party machen. Und sie findet vor allem ihren neuen Sänger, den Dennis, der tut seine Stimme so richtig gut schonen. Nicht wie ihr letzter Sänger, haben sie gesagt. Und der letzte Sänger, das war der sogenannte Danny gewesen. Und das hat einen riesen Umschwung gegeben der Band. Nämlich im Januar hat der Ex-Sänger gefunden, dass er seine andere Band hat, We Are Harlots, wird weiterführen und somit die Band Asking Alexandria Dutz verlassen. Ja, fast ein bisschen schade Geschichte und wir haben probiert ein bisschen herauszufinden, wie sie jetzt darauf reagieren. Sie sagen, es ist so, es ist eine dumme Geschichte, aber sie wird es nicht alles bei bösem Blut lassen, nein, sie wird lieber einfach vorausschauen können und im neuen Album ein bisschen über Positives schreiben. Und somit nicht über einfach den Danny wollen ablästern, sondern sagen, weißt du, wir sind eine neue Band und jetzt geht es in eine neue Richtung. Sie sind vor allem noch in Kontakt mit dem Danny. You still in contact with Danny, as you just said. The best thing is when the bands are listening to Swiss German, it's like, oh, it's very funny language.
I heard the words Danny and Noblash, so I think that's...
Noblash. Anyway, so the funny thing is that Danny will actually be here tomorrow as well. We're having me here on the sofa for an interview. Yeah. Is there anything you want to say? Just say hi or anything? Or it's like...
Nah.
Nah, not really.
Not really.
You don't have to.
Do you want to say hi?
So you actually have been not in too good terms. You gotta be honest, but it's all right.
No,
it's my.
Honestly, it's fine. I'm
it's okay. All right, that's okay.
It's completely fine.
Yeah. Anyway, so you got a new album coming out in autumn. So you said somewhere, didn't you? You got a new song out called. Sorry, I've got to check this. I Won't Give In, which is quite good. With a new singer who actually looks for his voice.
Yeah.
But is it gonna be a song about unfinished tattoos? Or is it finished?
No, it's it's
is
been
it like that.
It's been unfinished for like 2 or 3 years now. It's really annoying. If my tattoo artist is watching this, you're a dick. Can you finish my arm?
Is it he who hasn't got the time for an unfinished tattoo?
It's a bit of both. I'm always on tour, and then when I get home, he's got a baby, and it's like, ugh. I might just colour it in every day.
But actually, the sound of tattooing is like zzz. Could be really like nice for babies' ears sometimes.
I was thinking.
Yeah, it's like, oh, like when you drive a car, it's like.
But the high-pitched girly screams coming from my mouth might wake it up, though.
Also, sie haben ein neues Album, das im Herbst rauskommt, sagen jetzt. Und natürlich auch ihr neues Album, besser gesagt, ihr neues Single, I Won't Give In. Und ich habe natürlich gefragt, haben sie auch einen Song darüber, wo es darum handelt, dass Tattoos noch nicht fertig sind? Er findet, sie 2, 3 Jahre ist das Tattoo noch nicht fertig. What is it, by the way? It looks like some kind of Loch Ness Monster, Bigfoots, kind of dinosaur.
Basically, this is a mad scientist depicting God ripping open his rib cage, and there's a clock instead of a heart, like time's running out. This guy down here is fucking battling with some demons. It's basically the lyrics from the final episode.
That's the brain, isn't it?
The brain. It's fallen out of his head.
I love the fact that you have it.
But you've got to speak in the microphone.
On your hand. Yeah. I just think that is just the greatest thing in the world.
It's awesome, isn't it?
So if the brain here can't think anymore, the brain there will be able to think for you.
It goes here to here, then there. Yeah. So.
Well said. Well, I won't keep you any longer. I'll leave you with your drinks. Have a good time. Have a good time on stage tonight.
Oh, yeah.
What will we be expecting from you, and especially a new singer, except for the new voice, which we already know now?
Just, we'll be happy on stage for once. We won't look all miserable and worried about what our singer's going to do next. We'll actually be smiling, having a good time. The crowd will be able to sing along because they know what's being sung. It's going to be good.
All right, also man sieht, auch wenn sie zum Teil sagen, es ist eigentlich alles okay zwischen ihr und ihrem Ex-Sänger, ist es doch noch nicht ganz so gut, aber es ist eine sehr interessante Geschichte. Wir werden es weiterverfolgen und wir wünschen der Band und ihrem neuen Sänger viel, viel Glück. Der Dennis wird sicher die Bühne rocken hier am Greenfield Festival 2015 und natürlich auch noch die Band Asking Alexandria. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much, mate.
Thank you.
And now you can fly away. With your brain hands and everything.
My brain hands, back to my the brain hands and my booze.
And your booze, yeah, exactly. All right, thank you very much.
Oh, yeah,
Professor.
Thank you, mate.
Good thing very talking fun. About it when we said, no, we shouldn't be showing that we've got B here. It could be anything but this, man.
No, this is the way it is. This is apple juice.
It's apple juice.
Well,
that was a quick. Shouldn't show that, I guess. Shouldn't show that. Also, ihnen geht's gut. Sie haben etwas zu trinken da. Sie sind natürlich zufrieden und wir sind auch zufrieden. So you arrived. It's raining in Switzerland. You're in Switzerland. I mean, what's about that? Normally it's mountain sunshine. Normalerweise ist es Bergen und Sonnenschein. Und jetzt regnet es da am Greenfield. Man sieht es da natürlich in dem Moment nicht. Aber was ist Ihre Meinung dazu? The rain in Switzerland. I mean, you have got that in England already. Why should you go to other countries and it rains on your head? I mean, that's just bad.
That's what I'm saying. And we woke up and it was sunny and we were hot. And we were like, yes, this is awesome. Look how beautiful it is. There were naked women walking around. It was awesome, but strange. And then it started raining and they all put their clothes back on.
That's actually really sad. I mean, normally it's good when the women stay naked. I guess also the men sometimes, because the women also like to see, like, you know, naked upper body from men sometimes.
Not me.
Although I'm not me either. I mean, I'm not a fan of that, you know, taking my clothes off, because, you know, it's just...
going on under
really
this.
A dad bod, yeah. You can't see a dad bod.
I pretty much look like
a little boy,
like a seven year old boy. Yeah,
that's because he has a small.
Also, das Wetter ist momentan gut, weil sie sagen, hey, heute Morgen war es schön, die Frauen sind nachts rumgelaufen und jetzt hat es angefangen zu regnen und die Frauen haben ihre Kleider wieder angezogen. Was fast ein bisschen schade ist, ich habe gefunden, für Frauen wäre es ja eigentlich schön, auch wenn man sich die Mann ausziehen würde. Er findet nein, vor allem er wird das selber nicht ausziehen, weil er hat einen Dadbod. Das ist ja dort, wo man das sogenannte kleine Büchli. I know the word that, but it's there we got like little. Wir sind noch am Greenfield Festival 2015 und neben mir jetzt die Band Asking Alexandria. How are you doing, guys?
Good, man. Just trying to get drunk, but I got told I had to hide my beer thingy, so I had to get another thingy to put my beer in, and it's really complicated.